Hi, it's Corey, and this is Let's Play Ukulele, Lesson 5, Learning How to Read Strumming Patterns. So when you are talking about a strumming pattern, what we're talking about is a repetitive pattern in which you use to strum the ukulele. In general, there are three main ways that people write out strumming patterns. Now, there are some other ways out there, but like I said, these three ways are the most common that are shared amongst different method books, in addition to where you see on tutorials and on other areas on the internet. The easiest way how to write out a strumming pattern is just to use directional arrows. When you have an arrow going up, it means an up strum. When you have an arrow going down, it means a down strum. So for instance, if I were to go down, up, down, up, you can see on the screen, I have an arrow going down and then up, down, and up. And that tells me the direction in which I need to strum. Down, up, down, up. Like we talked about in the last lesson, if you're going with just down strums, you can totally use your thumb. And if you're doing up strums, you can also use your thumb, but the pointer finger works best when you're alternating between the two. Now, you can also use letters to represent those strumming patterns. This is, I would say, probably of the three, the most commonly used way, but very basically you use a D and almost always capital letters, but you use a D to represent the down strum. You use a U to represent the up strum. And then also, when it comes to chucking, often you'll see a capital letter C for chucking or an X for the chuck as well. I know in my tutorials, I use X to represent chucking. The final way in which to read strumming patterns are to use a combination of numbers and the plus sign. Now, this is really heavily connected to counting in music theory. So for instance, if you have a time signature of 4-4, which is probably the most common time signature that people know, even if they're not super familiar with music theory, that would be 4 beats per measure, and then the quarter note gets the beat. And when you're counting that, it's when people say 1, 2, 3, 4, and then they start back over at 1. There are a lot of different time signatures, and there's a lot of different ways you can count, but I find that most pop music, it's going to be in 4-4. Or some division of it in which you can still use counting up to 4. What the numbers mean are typically when you're using a whole number, you're going to be having a down strum. When you have an and or the plus sign, you're going to be using an up strum. So for instance, if I had down, up, I would count it 1 and 2 and. So if I wanted to count all the way to 4, I'd have to go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. One advantage of using the counts is that you're going to have a much better representation of how that strumming pattern fits within the overall rhythmic scheme of the song. Whereas if you're using arrows or the letters to write out the strumming pattern, there are some ways in which you can interpret that, which won't always be true to the song. So your next step would be to go to the workbook and fill out the guided notes and practice out some of those different ways that you can read and write strumming patterns. At the end of the day, I would say use whichever way you are most familiar with, but you will be practicing them throughout this video series. So I will see you in the next video, which will be Lesson 6, Basic Strumming Patterns.